Got him. Beautiful stuff from Wasim. Clever bowling. A couple of spinners in operation now. Bowling a little bit similar. And that has certainly made an impact.
Yeah, speared and pushed it in a bit quicker, a bit flatter. And really, not even halfway up the stumps. Shows an extra flatter trajectory.
From the last match, Munro made 100. They only made 162. Oh, got him. Got him. Quicker, flatter. Arm ball from Wasim. It was an absolute beauty, and it got through McCullum before he got that big bat down.
He got the length wrong. Just was swung in the arm ball. No turn.
Mid on.
Out. Got one. Guptill goes, and the Tulawas are in the game.
Oh, it built. It built and it built. Sending instructions from the sidelines. It's another slider arm ball. Guptill tried to give himself a bit of room to go over the offside. Couldn't get it over the head of McCarthy.
Oh, no!
Got him. That's the end of Smith. We got a game on here this evening.
Fantastic stuff. Once again, it's the arm ball, not looking to turn it, looking to bowl as straight as possible. Dwayne Smith has played all round a straight one.
Big shout, out. Had to be out.
All happening. Smith goes for the sweep. He feels disappointed.
He does go again. Chance in the deep, out. Russell, he's the man. With ball, with bat, and in the field as well.
Charged it, did it hit the toe of the bat? That's why he couldn't get more elevation. And Russell is in that high traffic area where they're expecting a lot of opportunity.
Gone. All ends up. Sangakkara with the stumping. Wasim gets the wicket, and McCullum walks off.
It's all wickets. Not sure about that. Just hasn't given himself enough time tonight, McCullum.
It's a full toss, cries a catcher. That should be taken, and it is taken. That is an important wicket for the Tulawas.
Imad Wasim, low full toss, and Munro, well, didn't have the power and distance.
Cries of catcher, picked out Chris Gayle, so they've got another one, the Tulawas. Real problems here, one blow from Barnwell, the next one he just holds out to the skipper.
Says it all, just fatted one over the fence for six, now bottom of the blade only.
Gone. That's out. Wow.
Only had 70 runs, but now we've got six wickets. Say the Tulawas.
A dozen years. I've been very impressed with the work he does with both bat and ball. Oh, goodness me. Unless he steps outside his crease. A wide is called, but that's okay. You get stumped off a wide. Another one goes down.
Oh, he's knocked him over. Inside edge. And Imad Wasim strikes. And it's Kyron Pollard who's bewildered.
Brilliant bit of bowling. A quicker delivery. The arm ball, I think it was, from Imad Wasim. There it is. Quicker delivery. Kept a little bit low, to be fair, to Pollard. He'll look back on that and see the vision of that and think, well...
That's another one gone. What did he do round there? Imad Wasim is having a ball in this first game for the Tulawas in 2017. Two wickets to him now.
Quicker delivery, angling in, the arm ball. Now, you asked me the question whether Pollard should have been forward. That was Fuller.
Oh, he's done him. He's gone right through Kane Williamson. And another fine piece of bowling takes that off stump.
A little bit quicker, pushed through, flatter, and just skidded through. Williamson playing down the wrong line. That's a big scalp.
And again. Would it be taken? Yes, comfortably so. McCarthy, I think. Makes a simple catch, looking for the boundary. Another wicket down.
Monster sinks the ball before this one. Couldn't stay down on it long enough on this occasion. Got up and under. And Narine goes after him straight away. But it doesn't come off. An early wicket. It's Rodman Powell with the wicket. And there's a celebration if ever I saw one.
And the left-handers, again, it's that arm ball. Seam up. And Narine tugs it down to long on.
20 internationals.
Yeah! Oh, taught him up. And Imad Wasim strikes. It's a fine celebration, El Dorado, from Imad.
Ben Cutting, a better length ball to pick, but you could see his front leg didn't cover the line of the stumps. Imad Wasim comes back into the attack.
It's gone way up in the air. Two men converging upon it. Who wants it? Oh, well, who do you think? Rodman Powell takes the catch, and it was a steepling catch. Good hands, and he just kept his nerve.
Catch! Has he got enough off the toe of the bat?
Yeah!
Yes, he's gone. Russell making huge ground at mid-on, running back towards the boundary. And he goes early off the toe of the bat, looking to launch it. Over mid-on, but Russell's too quick, too athletic.
Yeah!
Bolded!
Imad Wasim celebrates.
From around the wicket, he knew exactly what he was doing. He was always looking to get it underneath the bat, at the batsman's feet. And yes!
He's got to go, not hard enough! So, 2 nights in a row, Cornwall is caught in a similar position.
Andre Russell, and in his last game for the Tullywars, Imad Wasim comes up, look at that. Made it look simple, and it wasn't.
Oh, that's out, is it? That's out, it is out, yeah. Looked like it pitched on leg stump to me and was crashing into the stumps as well. Narine.
That's out, it's out, brother. Like pitching on. Yeah, I think you're fair. Pitching on about leg and just sliding on.
Horrible. Oh, edged and out and gone.
Yeah, a little bit surprising, I think, for Munro, but he's just got a little top edge. Light juggle, half a juggle, perhaps. Good healthy edge, or hit the thumb. And then straight into that.
Significantly, if they win this contest. Oh, missed it by a long way. Exceptional work from Imad Wasim. And of course, the work done behind the stumps as well.
Big smiles. Oh, he's charged a long way down here. And he's missed it by next week. Huge.
He's bowled him. Took a long while to see the finger.
The decision is LBW. Yeah, plumb in front. He does, cleans him up. Castle just skidded on off the surface. And an early strike for Imad Wasim.
From Pakistan, Imad Wasim. Just using the angle from round the wicket, going through the defences of Brandon King for the Warriors.
Beautifully bowled. Wonderful bowling, Imad Wasim. That's why he is so clever and he's been so successful. Good work behind the stumps from Chadwick Walton as well. Less said about the shot, the better. Oh, dear. It's absolutely plumb in front. I wasn't sure, I just felt that I might have heard an inside edge, but if not, that is front pad, back pad, and gone.
That onside into the breeze.
Oh, the spin of Imad Wasim, too much for the South African youngster.
Love it loads. Here's a little flick. It just dips here, gets an inside edge, and again, wanting to go.
Now catch it out.
Straight in, another one down. Chris Green is a safe pair of hands.
Required reads. Always as a batter pushes you to manufacture strokes. Desperate need of a boundary.
Ideally up the ante a little. Yeah! Oh yeah, they're celebrating here. Kenar Lewis thinks yes. And Gregory Brathwaite has other ideas, but he says, look, chaps, just calm down and have a little chill moment because I'm going to catch up with my mate Patrick Gustard. That's all okay. Maybe just looking for a possible bump ball. Just have a look here.
Chance, size, clothed it. Absolutely clothed it to Brandon King. Imad Wasim has struck, and it's a big blow, Tim David.
Newly Australian international, Tim David. Just clothed it, like you said, Dooley. Just sliced the ball. Didn't.
Ball and ball!
And he misses. Ah! Imad Wasim is such a crafty performer.
The opposition have got some stars just quietly. And Imad Wasim, smart bowling, brilliant. Close the angle down and arms aloft to get rid of the big fish.
Rampal. Doesn't get hold of it. And it's Imad Wasim. Lewis goes after him straight away. But doesn't clear the fence. Chris Green with a Republic Bank classic catch.
50 comes up. Wasn't that short from Evan Lewis? Would have hit the stump maybe two-thirds of the way up had it gone past him. Excellent timing from Green.
Keep working at it. That's a beauty. There's that bounce. Is he bowling? It's all good. Now then.
Might be out. Should be out and is comfortably taken. So his stay comes to an end. Gordon takes the catch and Imad Wasim strikes again.
Line depending on what the batter is doing.
And another one. He's gone straight past that, has Bosch, and Imad Wasim has got three for none in two overs. And the Barbados Royals, the table-topping Barbados Royals, are in all sorts of trouble.
Left-arm spin of the highest order from the Pakistan international. The pace, just 87 kilometers per hour. Batting option available to Pollard, that is Leonardo Julian. But no discussions here for Colin Munro because he's not made contact with this one.
And if you look at the lips of Sukut, he was mentioning that they were bowling too full. That's the length.
This time in the power play.
Very full, very, very full.
And a bit of tracking. Yeah, it's all good. Pitched on leg stump at least.
Swept. Raymond Reefer settles and completes the catch. A Republic Bank classic to get rid of Naroshan Dequela.
Wasim's contributions, particularly with the ball and that arm ball. When he bowls with that new ball in the power play, the majority of it is that arm ball with Wasim.
To cut that single. Could be a catch. It is a catch. A wonderful catch, Mohammed Nabi.
Got him. He's got him. Yeah, he held on to it, did Kenar Lewis. I wonder whether it might have fallen down, but it hit the gloves, then went between those enormous thighs.
Machi bubbled one and then effected the stumping. On this occasion, another bubble off his hard hands, captures it in time. And sparking.
Gone! Pressure's just mounting all the time for Kemo Paul and the Warriors. It's the big, big nail in the coffin of GAW.
Length is crucial here, in that it's not right.
Bolden, swing and a miss. Very good from Imad. He's been good throughout the tournament, putting his hand up again for the player of the tournament against the man he's probably in competition with.
And we don't know, but two great all-rounders. Imad Wasim getting the better of Jason Holder. That angle again.
Big, big prize there.
There is a long on. Only two fielders outside of the circle, and Fafa's picked out one. And Imad Wasim, so often he strikes in this power play.
A bit wider, but you're up against this guy, Imad Wasim, who just cramps you because of the angles he creates from left arm round.
Later in the actual innings.
Raza. Gone. Been a struggle for him. Tried to break the shackles but can't. And it's Wasim again in the wickets. This is another one. Amir Jangu celebrated straight away, but Wasim wasn't interested. They've sent it upstairs.
Well, two wickets to fall. An over number 14. Just nine runs in that over. Is that...
Didn't know much about that, and it'll be comfortably taken at third. Another one down for the Patriots, and Imad Wasim strikes.
What the doctor ordered. Yeah, hadn't known too much about the rest of the over.
Bolden, second delivery, pitching wicket to wicket. And he gets the dangerous Cornwall. So again, momentum shifting.
And was right on the stumps, bowling straighter, which he does so well to right-handed batters in the power play. Got him. And the slow start does not work. It's playing Russian roulette at times with trying to make up at the back end. Sometimes it works. Today it doesn't.
Who of the pressure was on because he hasn't been scoring frequently or as freely as he wanted.
Gone leg side, fielder there, completes the catch. Jermaine Blackwood matching up with Imad Wasim and getting rid of Nicholas Puran, the dangerous Puran.
Left-hand orthodox to left-handed batter. He makes the adjustment in line, Imad Wasim. A good catch.
Just short.
Is it? It's taken. That's another type of Superman. Fabian Allen diving forward. For a moment you felt the ball didn't get to him. But what an El Dorado celebration. Wow. Seen in this edition of the Republic Bank CPL.
Yeah, no surprises who has taken that catch. We saw, as I mentioned before, a left-hander in Florida.
Straight up. Oh, dear. Lewis under pressure. Catch taken. And Evan Lewis's horror season continues.
For Imad Wasim, trying to take on the fielder in the deep. with the wind, the smaller side, but the bounce just his undoing. A good catch.
Fielder, it's into the wind. And we think that Jermaine Blackwood, who's on the field as a substitute fielder, has done enough.
Not hit it, should be taken. Safely held, but lovely little teasing flight from Imad Wasim.
Change of pace, slower, wider. Raymond Rifa.
What a strike, but it's in the wind. And Springer takes it beautifully in the end. Finally, the partnership is broken.
Well, he had to get on with it. It was up there. It was certainly there for the shot. Just got it a little bit low on the blade. But that is magnificent from Springer. Yeah. Ah. Given. Ninth nail in the coffin here for the St. Lucia Kings. No referral. That's it.
In there, down the ground. Fielder goes around it and takes the catch. Chris Green is an exceptional fielder. The composure, close to the boundary, really well done.
Colin Munro, a man who is accustomed to playing in these must-win matches, playing in the playoffs round.
Oh, gone! Threw him, the length pulled back, and gets his man in the end. After being put to the sword.
Lanky saw Fletcher coming, pulled it back, and it was very close for Fletcher. Couldn't make the adjustment. Needed to get bat on ball. There he goes. Yeah, just
last night, I'm being reliably informed. Oh, it's calls of catch it. It's high. He hasn't got hold of this. Lots of wind, but he held on to it.
On against the wind. He said that to Imad Wasim. Make him hit into the wind. He's tried to fetch that from outside the off stump. It's actually spun away from him a little. And thank goodness for youth, awareness, and reflexes.
Pull him! Straight through! The pressure has told! They've kept it on.
Two right-handers at the crease. He wasn't trying to play a big shot. Just trying to work it leg side, maybe to get a single or a couple. Goes leg side now. This should be taken. Should be a wicket. Should be the breakthrough. It is. Fabian Allen, that's as easy as it gets for him. And this time he perishes. A much needed breakthrough for the Falcons.
Trying to find something to change their fortunes. And it's a wicket. Imad Wasim with the breakthrough for the Falcons.
Something to cheer for the Falcons. Followed him. After three dot balls, had to try and get himself away. Probably not necessarily searching.
Hasn't got this one at all, but it is swirling. Wasim gets it on the second attempt.
153 for seven.
Will be a wicket to end, so double strike for the Falcons, but it crucially 33 runs come from the last two overs. How pivotal could that be?
Yeah, you can understand Virasamy Pamal having to do that. Certainly not the head to wait. Beautiful bowling. Should be is number two. Brandon King with a very comfortable catch to get rid of Mutti. Openers and then three and four are such specialist positions. That's a comfortable catch.
Straight through. Again, the spin of the Falcons working and working well. This is why he's arrived.
Well, he does prefer bowling to right-handers, does Imad Wasim. And this season, six against the righties,